An estimated 90% of patients don't use their pressurized metered dose inhaler right. So 90% of patients get less medicine reaching the right part of the lungs, and that results in poor disease control, more side effects, and more hospital admissions. And that's not a good thing. This week's video is all about inhaler technique, but make sure to watch it all because at the end of it, I promise you, you'll be a metered dose inhaler pro. So please like, share, and tag a friend so more people can learn these vital skills. Now let's begin. This is my placebo inhaler. It will have a different color to your inhaler, but the mechanism on all of them are the same. So let's take a closer look. Here is a small canister which contains a mixture of medicine and propellant. It's held in a plastic case called the actuator. When you press the canister down, the actuator nozzle produces a fine spray which you breathe in. Now that you understand the mechanism of the inhaler, here's why you need to shake the inhaler before every puff. The drug needs to mix with the propellant, so if you don't shake, you're going to get more propellant than medicine. So it's a similar concept to deodorant and spray paint. Now, let's go back a little. Imagine you've just picked up your inhaler from your pharmacy. It's all new and shiny. But are you priming your inhaler? I see so many patients that don't do this, and every manufacturer has different instructions. So make sure to read the information leaflet. To prime the inhaler, it usually means doing two sprays away from yourself, like so, and now it's primed. So that means you get the right amount of medicine when you use it. Remember, you only need to prime your inhaler the first time you use it, or if you haven't used it for a while. So always read your information leaflet for clarification. Now, let's use our inhaler. Stand or sit upright. Remove the cap from your inhaler and give it a good shake, because we all now know why. Hold your inhaler like this and not upside down. Keep your thumb on the base and your index finger on the canister. Breathe out gently and put the mouthpiece in your mouth like so. It's important to wrap your lips around it and not bite it. Now, let's observe the correct inhaler technique in action with commentary. Observe. When the mouthpiece is in your mouth, breathe in slow and deep. Just after you begin to breathe in, press the canister down and continue to inhale. Remove inhaler from your mouth and continue holding your breath for 10 seconds or as long as it's comfortable, then breathe out gently. That was amazing. If you have to take another dose, repeat the process again after 30 to 60 seconds. Don't forget to shake your inhaler. And when you've finished, always replace the mouthpiece cover to avoid any dust from getting in. And that's it for this week's video. You're now a metered dose inhaler pro. And hopefully you can advise your friends and family on how to use your inhaler properly. If you're ever unsure, you can always double check your inhaler technique with your pharmacist, nurse practitioner, or GP. So just ask. Remember, cold weather can trigger asthma attacks. So please help spread this video by liking, sharing, and tagging a friend who needs this. I also made a video explaining what to do in an asthma attack. So if you have time, feel free to check it out. Link is in the description below. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you haven't already, hit that follow or subscribe button now to get more videos.